Welcome to the Kidz Newz. We're gonna tell you about some fun things to do. This is the Kidz Newz! Yeah!
Hey kids, welcome to the Kidz Newz. I'm your host, DTV. I hope you're staying cool this summer because it's been hotter than blue blazes outside. Maybe I should explain what that means. Look closely at this video of a burning candle. You should be able to see that the bottom of the flame is blue. That part of the flame is the hottest part of the fire. It's about 2,550 degrees. Wow, that's really hot. We've had several days this summer where the temperature has been 95 degrees or greater, but has never been 2,550 degrees, so I guess the expression hotter than blue blazes is an exaggeration. Maybe I should explain what an exaggeration means. You exaggerate when you say something is bigger or greater than it is. Like if you say, "My dog is as big as a school bus." Your dog might be big, but no dog is as big as a school bus. You would be exaggerating. That's a fun word to say. You might hear it again in today's newscast. So listen closely. And at the end of the show, see if you heard all the times we exaggerate in this episode. Now let's join Candy with some news from our local libraries.
Steve, I'm glad you mentioned school buses, because schools will soon be back in session. Preschoolers, I know that sometimes you get a little sad when you see your older brothers and sisters getting on the school bus. Not to exaggerate, but you might feel like it'll be a million years before you can start school. But you don't have to sit at home and fret. You can start preparing for school now. On Saturday, August 13th, from 3 till 5 at the Sibylan Community Library, or on Saturday, August 20th, from 11:30 till 1:30 at the East Regional Library in Knightdale. You can check out an event called Ready, Set, School. Marble's Kids Museum will be at these libraries to help kids ages 3, 4, and 5 get ready for school. You will have fun exploring reading, math, language, and problem-solving skills. And then you can go home and practice what you learn. But don't stop there, because 3, 4, and 5-year-olds can also attend the ABC Craft and Learn classes going on every Saturday morning from 10:30 to 11:30 at both the Wendell and Zeeblin Community Libraries. You will learn about letters like ABC and XYZ by creating an alphabet craft. And you'll learn about reading and writing too. Don't those sound like great ways to get ready for school, Steve?
They sure do, Candy. But wait, I know another way our viewers can get ready for school. The East Wake Education Foundation is planning a program called Ready, Set, Read for 4- and 5-year-olds who will start kindergarten next year. Each session will be about 3 weeks long and will be held 4 days a week for about 2 hours. So if you want to be even more ready for school, tell your folks to call Shannon Speller or Linda Johnson at the number shown on the screen for more information. My dog Biscuit is the smartest dog in the studio. And I'm not exaggerating. Just listen to this, and I bet you'll agree.
Hey kids, like my friend Steve said earlier, it's hot outside. Real hot. And I'm here to tell you right now, we are in the dog days of summer. Have you ever heard of the dog days of summer? Well, let me tell you about them. There's a very bright star that is called the dog star. In the winter season, you can see this dog star very clearly in the constellation called Canis Major. When you draw a line between all the stars in Canis Major, the constellation, it looks like a big dog. That's right. That's what a constellation is. It's a group of stars that makes a picture when you draw lines from star to star. It's like playing connect the dots, but with stars. Well, between July 3rd and August 11th, which is the hottest, muggiest part of the summer, the dog star doesn't come out when it gets dark. It comes out when the sun comes up. And it sits when the sun goes down. You can't see it since it's daytime, but it's there. And since the dog star is shining the same time as the sun, and since it's really hot outside, this is the time of year called the dog days of summer. I like the dog days of summer more than I like to chase cats, and I'm not exaggerating. My man Steve asked me to send you over to Calvin next. So, Calvin, are you enjoying these dog days of summer?
I am, Biscuit. Some people call them the lazy days of summer, but I'm here to tell the kids summer isn't over yet. And if you haven't been to Hill Ridge Farms in Youngsville, you should go. It's a great place to take the family, and right now, they have a splash pad with all kinds of fountains and water to keep you cool. The year-round activities are open too, like the train ride, the jumping pillow, and the farm. When I hopped on the jumping pillow, I bounced as high as the Nightdale water tower, and I'm not exaggerating. The splash pad closes on September 4th, so there's still time to enjoy it before the summer comes to an end. Now let's bounce on over to Tex and Zebulon.
Howdy, boys and girls. I'm here to tell you about Superhero Night at the Carolina Mudcat Stadium in Zebulon on Saturday, August 13th at 6 p.m. The first 1,000 kids ages 14 and under will get a superhero cape before the game, so be sure to get there early and claim your superhero cape. I already got mine. Up, up, and away! I'm not exaggerating when I tell you that I flew faster than a diesel train and now I'm at the Nightdale Station Park. On Friday, August 26th, the town of Nightdale will be showing the movie Avatar right here in the park. The movie starts when the sun goes down, so bring your chairs and blankets and come out for the free movie. Steve, don't you have some other news about some upcoming events in Nightdale?
Thanks for reminding me, Tex. On Saturday, September 10th from 10 a.m. till 7 p.m., you should plan to attend K-Fest at the Nightdale Station Park. K-Fest is a new festival in Nightdale which will feature a student talent show, backpack and school supply giveaway, local bands and artists, inflatables, and the bookmobile. Did I mention food trucks? Haha, it sounds like a blast, so mark your calendars for K-Fest in Nightdale. Tex, did I hear correctly that you have now flown over to Roseville?
Yes indeedy, Steve. I am here at the Roseville Middle School football field where they will be showing a free outdoor movie on August 13th at 8:15. The movie is the Lego Movie, so bring some money for concessions and enjoy the movie on the football field without worrying about being tackled by football players. Back to you, Steve.
That's good to know, Tex. Thanks. Kids, I was just reading the Total Connection newspaper. You can find these all over Wake County. The Total Connection newspaper tells you about all kinds of fun things happening in our area. We can only cover so much here on the Kidz Newz, so pick up a newspaper or check them out online. So, how many times did you hear the word exaggeration in this episode? If you said 100, you would be exaggerating. Ha! You should have heard it about 5 times.
Like it'll be a million years before you can start school.
My dog, Biscuit, is the smartest dog in the studio.
I like the dog days of summer more than I like to chase cats.
I bounced as high as the Nightdale water tower.
I'm not exaggerating when I tell you that I flew faster than a diesel train.
Did you get all these? Well, that's it for this edition of the Kidz Newz. Enjoy those lazy dog days of summer. And don't forget to keep your diapers dry and your shoes tied.